today I'm making a keema kofta curry.
Here are the ingredients for the kofta, and next I will show you the ingredients for the curry. You can make this recipe with mutton keema or chicken keema. I have taken 250 grams of mutton keema, and whenever you are making koftas or kebabs, make sure they are washed well and drained off very well so that there is absolutely no moisture in it, else your koftas or kebabs are going to break as soon as you put them in the gravy. Secondly, when buying keema for koftas or kebabs, ask for a very fine keema. If it is not fine, then pulse it once or twice in your mixer or grinder. By grinding the meat, it becomes elastic. I have pulsed my keema and I have also added some mint leaves and coriander.
Tablespoons of roasted black gram. In case if you do not have these black gram, then you can take about 3 tablespoons of besan flour, roast it on the pan, and then you can add to this. The reason why I'm using the roasted black gram is that it's going to give a binding to the keema. And then I have one green chili over here, 2 tablespoons of fried onions, and 1 tablespoon of desiccated coconut. I have roasted this because I always roast my desiccated coconut and keep it handy. In case if you do not have it roasted, it's okay, you can just add it like that. I've got a tablespoon of yogurt over here, and then in the spices, the reason why I'm adding yogurt is that it adds softness to the koftas. The koftas don't become hard like raw.
In the spices, I've got 1/2 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala or all spices. You will find the link on the video. 1/2 teaspoon of roasted cumin powder, and 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. You may alter according to taste. 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and salt.
The first step that I'm going to do is like grind the roasted gram dal, the fried onions and desiccated coconut and the green chilies. If you want, you can even grind the mint leaves and the coriander leaves together, which I've already done over here. I've already made a powder over here, and now we're going to add this to the adding the yogurt, the ginger garlic and all the dry spices, and give it a good.
Here the batter for the kofta is ready and I am shaping them. You may shape it into big koftas or into small koftas. I usually prefer small koftas because once you put them into the gravy, they tend to swell up, and if you are making small, then they become a slightly big, but don't make into very big balls. So I'm just taking it into my hand and rolling it and then placing it on a clean
plate. Here I've kept the ingredients for making the kofta curry. So here I have taken 1 large onion, which I have made into fried onions, or if you want, you have it ready in your house, you can take about 4 tablespoons of fried onions. Then I've got 1 teaspoon of char magas. You can substitute it with some cashews or poppy seeds. You can take about 10 to 12 cashews. Then I've got 2 tablespoons of roasted desiccated coconut, and then I've got 1/2 cup of yogurt over here. Then in the spices, I have got 1 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, salt to taste, red chili powder, 1 teaspoon or to taste, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Then I've got 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala powder. The very first step that I'm going to start is by grinding the fried onions and the desiccated coconut. Later on, I'm going to add the char magas and the yogurt, and going to make into a fine.
I have heated oil in a pan and it goes in the ginger garlic paste, and we'll saute. Now I'm adding all the dry spices except for the garam masala powder.
Few splashes of water so that the masala should not burn.
I'm going to add the grinded masala, and we're going to cook it till the water from the yogurt totally evaporates.
After roasting for a few minutes, my flame is, I've reduced it to low, and as you can see, the water from the yogurt has completely evaporated. So I'm just adding about 2 or 3 tablespoons of water and roasting it again on a low flame for about 7 to 8.
See, a lot of oil is leaving the sides of the pan. So now I'm going to add some mint leaves, coriander leaves and some green chilies. And now we're going to add about 1 teacup of water. If we need more, we can add, and we're just going to wait till it comes to a boil. The water has come to boil. Now I'm going to add the garam masala powder.
The balls that I prepared. Now in 250 grams, I could make about 20 to 23 balls. Now we're going to start putting into this, and we'll let it cook for about 8 to 10 minutes.
After adding the koftas, you're not going to put the spoon and stir it. Just we're going to do like this, mix it, and now I'm going to cover it and let it cook for about 8 to 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, my kofta curry is ready. You may do a taste test now, and if you see the consistency is what I want. If you want it more thick, you can cook it for a longer time, and it has left good amount of oil, and even the koftas are cooked, so now we can serve it. So friends, here our keema kofta curry is ready. You may serve it with some naan, kulcha, parathas, lachha parathas or bagara chawal.
Do give it a try, post me your comments and share my videos with your family and friends, and do like us on Facebook and subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching my video.